video, I'm gonna once and for all answer the question that I've been getting for quite a while now. What's my opinion on SARMs? Now, SARMs stand for Selective Androgen Receptor Modulators. Say that fast 5 times. Now, despite the fancy name, SARMs really aren't that complicated to understand, because if you understand testosterone, you basically understand SARMs. Now, the way that testosterone works in the body to enhance muscle growth is it actually enters the muscle cell where it attaches to a receptor known as the androgen receptor. Now remember, SARM stands for Selective Androgen Receptor Modulator. Now once the testosterone binds to this receptor, the receptor changes, and that change instigates actions that basically ramp up muscle protein synthesis, and that can lead to muscle growth in the long run. Testosterone is sort of a selective androgen receptor modulator, or at least an androgen receptor modulator, or an arm, if you will. Now the thing with testosterone is it not only produces gains in muscle size, the muscle gains you get and the strength gains are known as its anabolic properties. Now the other thing that testosterone is known for is for boosting sex drive, that deepening of the voice, more body hair, and even more aggression. So when it comes to even anabolic steroids in athletes, athletes are playing around with steroids that have a different anabolic to androgenic ratio. That means how much of the drug goes towards muscle growth and how much goes towards those androgenic properties, the boost in sex drive and aggression versus the boost in muscle mass, muscle strength enhancement, and fat loss. Now, those who remember the names of some old school anabolic steroids like Dianabol and Anavar, Dianabol was a more androgenic steroid. Not only did it increase muscle size and muscle strength gains, but it caused a lot of aggression as well. Anavar, on the other hand, bit more anabolic properties with less of the androgenic properties. Now with SARMs, it's sort of the same concept. SARMs are very selective in that they provide almost all anabolic properties with almost no androgenic properties. Sounds like the thing we've all been waiting for, right? Well, wrong. Now there are many problems when it comes to SARMs. They really do sound too good to be true, and that's pretty much the case. So where do I begin with the issues on SARMs? Well, let's start with side effects. Now even though SARMs don't cause those boosts in androgenic properties, and it's all pretty much anabolic property, boost in muscle size, boost in muscle strength, even fat loss with some SARMs. Now, not every SARM, each SARM is different, which is another issue. But anytime you boost your testosterone levels or the activity of testosterone in the body with an exogenous source, a source other than what your body is producing, it's gonna shut down or at least slow down your body's own production of testosterone. Now, you might be gaining too many anabolic properties, and what I mean by that is not too much muscle growth, but not enough androgenic properties. So what's gonna happen is your testosterone, your own testosterone, which is providing both anabolic and androgenic properties, like sex drive guys, if you're taking something that's all anabolic and it's lowering your own production, well, guess what? Your sex drive is gonna drop. You can deal with that, well, then that's your call. I don't judge, I'm just giving you the straight up facts. Now the other issue, like I said, is not all SARMs are created equal. There's a ton of them out there. Osterine, Anabolicum, S4, I could go on and on. But the problem is you need to know which one you're getting. And that's a huge problem. And I don't just mean knowing which one it is, I mean knowing whether or not you're actually getting what you paid for. A lot of the crap that's being sold on the internet is coming from China, and guess what? You're really not getting the full dose. If you're lucky, you're getting a lower dose. If not, in many cases, you're getting nothing. So if you can't even rely on getting SARMs that you know are not only the correct one that you wanted, but are an actual SARM and not just the garbage that you're paying for, if you do actually get it, then you have to worry about getting side effects. You might as well just go and buy steroids online. It's pretty much the same risk that buying steroids online is. So I'm not a supporter of SARMs. I've never tried them myself. I see no reason to, because I know how to do it properly. Like I said, the last thing you want to do is alter your testosterone, at least as a natural athlete. Look, like I said, I don't judge if you're a competitive athlete who needs to take anabolic steroids for sport. That's your decision. I certainly do not judge anyone's decision to do what they want with their body. I'm just saying, I don't see a reason for my own body to be using SARMs, because I know how to raise testosterone levels, my own testosterone levels, with the formula that I created, AlphaGym. There's no safer and more effective way to raise both total and free testosterone levels. And the data supports it. Real users, guys, take a look at the data that we have on subjects taking AlphaGym. An average increase of almost 70%, 70% boost in total testosterone levels. And it's all done by simply optimizing your body's own testosterone production. So don't risk it with SARMs. If you really want to boost testosterone, get leaner, get more muscular, get stronger, and boost your sex drive to boot, go with AlphaGym, guys. So keep those questions coming. I'll keep giving you those straight up answers. And as always, stay gym army strong.